So offer curve, this is a very important tool in the neoclassical trade theory. Actually, the offer curve represents the reciprocal demand supply of a country. That means in one hand, it explains the supply of export, and the other hand, it explains the demand for imports. So that means if there is a particular terms of trade, offer curve will show how the country will respond to a particular terms of trade. So in this case, it shows a relationship between three things. So number one is export, import, and the terms of trade. So if we consider that Px is the international price of X, Pxi, Pyi is the international price of Y. So Pxi by Pyi equals to, we consider Pi. And capital X is the export of X, and capital Y is the import of Y. So in this case, there is a relationship that actually we say Px into X will be equal to Py into Y. So, or Px by Py equals to Y by X. So in case we can say that Pi equals to Y by X. So there is a relationship between three things, volume of export, volume of import, and the international terms of trade. If one of these, two of these three, we know the value of any two, we can easily determine the value of the third one. So one more thing we have to remember whenever we are considering the offer curve, it does not matter how much we are producing. The amount of the commodity X that we are willing to export, that means the producers are willing to export, and the amount of Y that the consumers are willing to import. So it is not related to total production or total consumption, rather it is related to the volume of willingness to purchase by the consumers and the willingness to sell by the producers. So now we will draw the here is the technique of drawing the offer curve from the production possibilities curve. So in horizontal axis we are measuring export of X, and in vertical axis we are measuring import of Y. But in this diagram, in horizontal axis we are measuring the volume of X, and here we are measuring the volume of Y. So what we said, that we will find out at different terms of trade how much the country will be willing to export against how much volume of the import. So that means what is the offer of the country. So let us consider that this is the, I'll draw it better. Let us consider that this is the term, this is the production possibilities curve of a country. So we can write that TT dash is the production possibilities curve of a country. And right now, if we consider that autarkic price ratio is represented by the slope of the line P0. So initially, this is my equilibrium point. E0 is the autarkic equilibrium point, because before trade, TT dash is the consumption possibility locus of the country. So there will be no difference between production possibilities curve and consumption possibility locus. So now, this is I0, E0. So what we can say, if the international terms of trade is represented by the slope of P0, the volume of trade will become zero. So what we can do here, now we will draw a straight line in the from origin whose slope will be exactly equal to P0. So how to draw it? So here what I will do, I am trying to do it approximately with the rule of thumb. So this is the base, and I will take the perpendicular value same as this value. So approximately this is my first line T1, T0. So if terms of trade equals to T0, the volume of trade for the country will be 0. Now let us consider another term. So international terms of trade, if T0 and P0, that means if the slope of these two are same, that means if international terms of trade is exactly equal to the autarkic price ratio of the country, the volume of trade will be 0. The country will not export anything, country will not import anything. The slope of T0 and slope of P0 are same. Just one difference is that P0 is negatively sloped, because in this case we are showing the production and consumption, and here it is clearly we show that whenever the production or consumption of one commodity increases, other has to decline. But here, whenever the export of X increases, import of Y will also increase. So that's why we are drawing here the directly, that means positively sloped straight line. That is the only difference. Now, next we will consider some other terms of trade. So if Px by Py is greater than the autarkic price ratio. So I'll draw it here. So if it is represented by the slope of P1. Now what we will see? The country will come and purchase this production process from E0 to point F. The production point will shift from E0 to point F, because at point F now the production possibilities curve is tangent to the in terms of trade line. So P1 is the right now, P1 is the new terms of trade. So what will be the equilibrium? Equilibrium will be determined by the tangency of higher community indifference curve I1, and after trade P1 becomes the consumption possibility locus. So what we'll see? We will see here the country will export FG units of X and import GE1 units of Y. So this will be the export and this will be the import of Y. I am not detailing. So what we see? The country will reach to higher community indifference curve. So the terms of trade is represented by the slope of this line. So easy way to draw it, that you take this difference GF and GF and take the vertical distance E1G. This is GF, GF and E1G. So now this T1, the slope of T1 will represent the new terms of trade P1. So here what you see, this is the GF is exactly equal to OX1 and GE1 equals to X1 B1. So there what you see, the country export OX1 units of X and imports X1 B1 units of Y. So what we will see, B1 is the new trading point when terms of trade is T1, represented by the slope of T1. Now let us consider, there is a further increase in the terms of trade. So new point, production point will be H. Tangency of the production possibilities curve with the new terms of trade P2. So production point will shift from F to H, that means the country will further increase the production of X. And now new equilibrium point will be determined on the higher end difference curve I2. So this is the point E2. So here we find that country is exporting HK units of commodity X and importing KE2 units of commodity Y. So we will represent this trade triangle again in this diagram. So this is the OX2 is the export, and I will do it KE2. So KE2 So new terms of trade will be represented by the slope of the straight line T2, and the trading point will be now point B2. So when the terms of trade is represented by the slope of P2, that means here T2, trading point will become moved from B1 to B2. So if we draw the curve joining 0, B1 and B2, this is the offer curve of home country or this country, which is exporting X and importing Y. So similarly, in the opposite way, whenever we are considering another country which is exporting Y and importing X, we will find out another offer curve. And so if a country, so this is the country offer curve of a country which is exporting X and importing Y. So this is the country of exporting X and importing Y. And if we consider a country which is importing Y and exporting X, we will get this type of offer curve in the same way. So whenever we will discuss the intersection of two offer curves, that this will be the trading equilibrium point and the straight lines starting from the origin and passing through the point, the slope of this straight line will determine the will be the equilibrium terms of trade. So this is the way through which we can draw offer curve of each country and finally determine the equilibrium terms of trade in a two country, two commodity case.